वेलकम बैक अगेन टू ए न्यू वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल सेशन फ्रॉम बायोलॉजी बूस्टअप एंड इन दिस वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल सेशन वी गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट फ्रॉम द बायोटेक्नोलॉजी द वेक्टर डीएनए टेक्नोलॉजी सो नाउ लेट स्टार्ट एट फर्स्ट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ वेक्टर डीएनए इन मॉलिक्यूलर क्लोनिंग A vector is a DNA molecule used as a vessel to artificially carry foreign genetic material into another cell, where it can be replicated and expressed. A vector containing foreign DNA is known as recombinant DNA. The four major types of vector are plasmid vector, viral vector, cosmid vector, and artificial chromosome. Of those, the most commonly used vectors are plasmid vector. It is common to all engineered vector are an origin of replication, a multi-cloning site, and a selectable marker. Next, the properties of vector DNA. Now, the modern artificially constructed vectors contain essential components found in all vectors and may contain other additional features found only in some vectors. First, the origin of replication. Necessary for the replication and maintenance of the vector in the host cell. Second, the promoter. Promoters are used to drive the transcription of the vector's transgene as well as the other genes in the vector, such as the antibiotic resistance genes. Some cloning vectors need not have a promoter for the cloned inserted, but it is an essential component of expression vector so that the clone product may be expressed. Now, second, the cloning site. This may be a multiple cloning site or other features that allow the insertion of foreign DNA into the vector through ligation. Next, the genetic markers. Genetic markers for viral vectors allow for confirmation that the vector has integrated with the host genomic DNA. Next point, antibiotic resistance. Vectors with antibiotic resistance open reading frames allow for survival of cells that have taken up the vector in growth media containing antibiotics through antibiotics selection. Next, the epitope. Some vectors may containing a sequences for a specific epitope that can be incorporated into the expressed protein. It allows the antibody identifications for cells expressing the target protein. Now next, the receptor genes. Some vectors may contain a receptor gene that allow for identification of plasmid that contains inserted DNA sequences. An example is LacZ alpha, which codes for the N-terminus fragments of beta-galactosidase, an enzyme that digests the galactose. A multiple cloning site is located within LacZ alpha and an inserted successfully ligated into the vector will disrupt the gene sequence resulting in an inactive beta-galactosidase. Now next, the types of vector DNA. There are two types of vector DNA we can found. At first, the cloning vector, and second is expression vector. A cloning vector is a small piece of DNA that can be stably maintained in an organism and into which a foreign DNA fragment can be inserted for cloning purpose. The cloning vector may be DNA taken from a virus, the cell of higher organism, or it may be the plasmid of a bacterium. The vector therefore contains features that allow for the convenient insertion or removal of a DNA fragments to or from the vector. For example, by treating the vector and the foreign DNA with a restriction enzyme that cuts the DNA. DNA fragments thus generated contain either blunt end or overhangs known as streaky end. And vector DNA and foreign DNA with compatible ends can then be joined together by molecular ligation. After a DNA fragment has been cloned into a cloning vector, it may be further subcloned into another vector designed for more specific use. Now next, in case of expression vector, otherwise known as expression construct, it usually a plasmid or virus designed for gene expression in cell. The vector is used to introduce a specific gene into a target cell and can commander the cell's mechanism for protein synthesis to produce the protein encoded by the gene. Expression vectors are the basic tools in biotechnology for the production of proteins. The vector is engineered to contain regulatory sequences that act as enhancer and promoter region and lead to efficient transcription of the gene carried on the expression vector. The goal of a well-designed expression vector is the efficient production of protein, and this may be achieved by the production of the significant amount of mRNA which can be translated into protein.